Good evening. At this time, I'd like to invite out the class of 2019 President Ramon Martinez to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. If we could all please stand.
Okay. Ready? Is there a music cue? No. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing. I'd like to invite out Kayla Bullier for the national anthem, please.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
At this time, we can all enjoy taking a seat. Before we get started too far here, I would like to take the opportunity to thank the entire Terryville High School band and Mr. Keene for the live recording of the Pomp and Circumstance processional that we used to march onto stage tonight. Good evening and welcome, school and town dignitaries, faculty and staff, parents, family members, friends, and of course, our Terryville High School graduating class of 2019. Tonight, we celebrate the commencement of scholars, athletes, musicians, actors and actresses, artists and leaders, young men and women who have met the criteria set by the Board of Education and are now preparing to enter the workforce, the military, or a post-secondary institution of higher education. Making Our Mark, the title of our 2019 yearbook, and certainly an appropriate slogan for our graduating class. The yearbook's introduction references the theme's concept as an opportunity to acknowledge the impact one can have on their community and how kindness and empathy play a pivotal role in developing relationships. With this in mind, I would like to share a section from one of the numerous messages I received 2 weeks ago that exemplifies this very concept. The message goes like this. On Friday, both of our schools were at Holiday Hill. We were there for our senior trip. One of our students who struggled socially was very upset because he couldn't find a group of peers to hang out with, even after we tried to connect him with a number of our students. A group of Terryville students noticed him sitting at a table, upset, and they consoled him, offering for him to join their group for the day. He spent the entire day with this group. On the bus ride home, I sat with that student, and he was all smiles, raving about how much fun he had kayaking and filling me in about his new friends. The values built through this community have resulted in acts of incidental kindness like this to be common practice for our students. The kindness within this story traveled quickly with heartfelt warmth through the two school communities. For the family of that student, the act of kindness is something they will forever cherish and appreciate. While this story referenced just a handful of our students, we have seen that it could have been any number of them, and that is the mark of the class of 2019. Tonight's milestone ceremony will make us reminisce about the past and wonder curiously about the future. Each of our graduates will take their own paths and face their own uncertainties. However, the communities that these graduates decide to call home will be impacted just as THS, and for that, I am certain the future will be bright. Class of 2019, we thank you for all the experiences that made up the past 4 years, and we wish you nothing but the very best. Before I exit off and have our keynote speaker come up, I think we need to acknowledge some people that are in our audience. The men and women who have served or are currently serving in our military. Their sacrifice and dedication to our country's freedom is paramount in all that we do. If the audience would be so kind, I would like to ask those in attendance who are active or retired members of the armed forces to please stand if able and be recognized. If you'd be so kind to remain standing just for another 2 minutes, please. At this time, I would like to recognize the members of the class of 2019 who have recently enlisted in the United States military. This year, we have two individuals wearing the red, the white, and the blue cords, designating their commitment to the armed forces. I ask that the following individuals please stand and be recognized. Kayla Huginski for the Army National Guard. And Cody Lozier for the U.S. Army. Thank you for those who have served and those who will be serving. You may take a seat. At this time, it is my honor to introduce the Mayor of Plymouth, Mr. Mayor Merchant.
Thank you, Mike. Those are some great words, and that was a great story for whoever was involved with that. I do love the energy in the room tonight. You know, it's an exciting night. I can honestly say that when I sat here and my son was up here, I spent most of the night fighting back tears, so it's okay. Anybody wants to do that? I want to welcome everybody here tonight to the graduation for the class of 2019, but I first want to thank the class of 2019 for allowing me to be part of this special night in your lives. You know, I sat in my office this week and I tried to come up with, you know, what I wanted to say to you tonight. And all I could think about was a time in my life, about 55 years ago, I got to be careful with those numbers, 55 or so years ago, and I was a young high school student. I was part of a youth group in my church, and I was asked to give a sermon on Sunday. So I accepted the challenge and said, okay, I can do that. And it would be the first time that I would ever have to speak in public, and especially for a congregation full of adults. And you know how there's things that just stay in your mind and you always remember? Well, I'll never forget that speech. And what I remember about that speech is how it began. The first line that I said that day was, "The world we live in today is a world of turmoil and confusion." And I've never forgotten that. And as I sat there this week, I could easily begin a speech tonight or any other night, and I could use the exact same opening line. So I guess the question that I have is, you know, what have we accomplished over the last 50 years? You know, that's the world that I was sent out into here over 50 years ago. And here we are 50 years later, about to send you into the same world. And maybe you guys have a little bit more turmoil, a little bit more confusion than my generation did. And sometimes I wonder, other than technology, what's improved? You know, today we've got computers, cell phones, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, text, Snapchat, computer games, apps, more than I can list. My car almost drives itself, and we actually have vehicles out there that drive themselves. Now, and I have a question that during the day, as long as I got my watch on, I got my cell phone with me, I just ask Siri. I'm in my car, and I have some place to go. I tell her where I want to go. The map pops up. She tells me how to get there, and there I am. And then when I'm home, I got Alexa. And somehow she has all the answers. You know, I can ask her any question, and she has every answer. And sometimes, you know, we've had times where we've had a conversation going on, and somehow Alexa pops in, and she wants to be part of it. You know, with all that technology, even with all the technology that we have, we still live in a world of turmoil and confusion. And I, for one, honestly, I'm ready for a change. And I think I look to you, the class of 2019, to begin that change. You, along with the seniors all across this great nation, let's not let technology consume our lives. 50 years from now, one of you are standing up here. Let's work toward a world that you can talk about without all the turmoil and confusion. Hopefully, that's possible. We need to learn from the mistakes of the past and not keep repeating them. It's never made any sense to me to see the same mistake repeated time after time, expecting a different result. Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "Learn from the mistakes of others. You won't live long enough to make them all yourselves." Learn from the mistakes of others, number one. And I can tell you, when you're out here in this world today, this world's all about competition. More so today than ever before. Every senior across this country is soon going to be competing with you for the job, the position, the promotion, whatever you may be involved in or something that you want. And when you compete in life, for whatever you're working towards, compete to win. Always play by the rules, but you must commit your life to excellence every day. And when you compete, compete to win. You know, legendary Green Bay Packer coach Vince Lombardi once said, and I have this hanging in my office, he said, "Your finest hour, your greatest fulfillment to all that you hold dear, is that moment when you have worked your heart out in a good cause and lie exhausted on the field of battle, victorious." Lastly, I'm going to ask you to live every day in the way that you want to be remembered. That's your legacy. And that's maybe the important thing, that the most important thing you can do. Your legacy is something that you're going to spend the rest of your life building. Make your legacy a good one. If you learn from the mistakes of others, commit every day for the rest of your life to excellence, you live every day in the way you want to be remembered, and guess what? The world's going to begin to change. Change takes place one day at a time, one person at a time. You can begin that change. Touch as many lives as you can along your journey. Help the people along the way that need your help. Give back to your community and to the people that helped you along your way. I want to thank you all for being part of our community, for sharing this part of your journey through life with us. You've made your community very proud. And I especially want to thank you for all the volunteer service that you perform. This community could not exist if not for volunteers. And I sincerely hope that your experience over these past 4 years will help you in the future give back to whatever community that you settle into, wherever that may be. You sit here tonight and complete your time here at Terryville High School, prepare to leave us. I would ask you all, remember us, remember your community, remember your hometown. I want to thank you all again for allowing me to share this night with you. Now as you leave, not only make your community proud, make your family proud, but most importantly, be proud of yourself. Thank you very much.
At this time, for the essayist address, I would like to invite up Ben Bodwin.
Good evening, Mayor Merchant, Police Chief Krasicki, members of the Board of Education, District Administration, Mr. Holtz, Mr. Vigliotti, faculty and staff, and our families and friends. Without all of you, none of us could be here today. Fellow graduates, today, June 13th, is the day that we, the class of 2019, graduate Terryville High School. For all 114 of us, this day marks quite possibly the most pivotal moment of our lives thus far. I know that we are all a bit anxious to officially graduate and see our friends and family, so I'll do my best to make this brief. Each morning, when we get up and approach the day to come, we are presented with dozens of choices, some as inconsequential as what shirt to wear, while others carry much more weight, such as whether to study for a major exam or go hang out with friends instead. Given the number of decisions we are forced to make over the course of a day, a month, a year, and a lifetime, it is inevitable that we will have some choices that are less than desirable. However, when you look back upon a particularly unwise choice with regret, guilt, or anger, try to bear one thing in mind. Humans are, have been, and will always be imperfect, and there is nothing that you or I can do to change that fact. Just how not perfect we are is much more prevalent than you may think. From our physiology, with our bodies poorly evolved to modern civilization, to our psychology, encompassing the innumerable flaws and imperfections of the human mind, making silly choices and mistakes is nothing but destiny for each and every member of our species. However, the seemingly uneven playing field of life set before us is not something we can sit back and treat as an excuse for our shortcomings. It is not acceptable to blame the stacked deck of life for what you failed to do. Instead, we must take up the reins of life, snap them tight, and drive life in the direction of our choosing, taking these occasional mistakes in stride. For after all, isn't the ability to get back up and keep going the most powerful measure of strength we humans possess? One approach that I have adopted after making a mistake is learning how to put the mistake into perspective. Take earlier this year, for instance. After I had completely bombed a test for my government class, I was beating myself up pretty badly for not preparing well enough. I tried to convince myself it wasn't my fault, the test was unfair, and other things like that, all to no avail. I finally was able to snap out of it only when I accepted that, yes, it was my fault for doing so poorly, but in the grand scheme of life, my grade of a 40 was about as inconsequential as a passing breeze, and there were better outlets for my time and energy than moping, lamenting that I should have spent more time studying as opposed to playing Minecraft. So, in the words of the famed band Smash Mouth, somebody once told me, the world is gonna roll me, I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. In all honesty, I think that is a pretty good metaphor for life as I have seen it so far. We are not perfect, and we can do incredibly dumb things from time to time. But at the end of the day, that's what makes us human, and isn't that what truly matters? Thank you. Now, it is my honor to introduce the class of 2019 salutatorian and my good friend, Logan Morneau.
Thank you, Ben. Good evening, Mayor Merchant, Police Chief Krasicki, Board of Education members, District Administration, Mr. Holtz, Mr. Vigliotti, faculty and staff, family, friends, and my fellow graduates. I learned recently about a concept called accelerating change, the idea that technology is not developing at a linear rate, but instead exponentially.
To better understand this, we must look back. History's best estimate for the invention of the wheel places it at about 3500 BCE, which is 5,500 years ago. 3,000 years later, paper was invented. The number zero didn't even exist in Europe until close to 350 AD. By comparison, the last 50 years have seen humanity travel to the moon, build the internet, and cure smallpox. Much more is happening in much shorter amounts of time. The last 4 years have been no exception. In 2015, the New Horizons probe rushed past Pluto at 10 miles per second. In 2016, MIT created a solar cell so flexible and lightweight that it can be draped on a bubble. In 2017, researchers found evidence of life from 4.4 billion years ago. Last year, a functional cure to HIV was discovered using CRISPR gene editing technology. Things are moving fast, and there is no reason to believe that humanity is slowing down. This is where we come in. Graduation is a rite of passage, representing the growth and maturity that accompany the leap into adulthood. As such, we are now the ones responsible for moving things along once we leave this building and step out into the world. However, this does not mean we can take it easy. Everything can and should be improved. One of my favorite quotes is one I first heard from Mr. Perkins: "Leave things better than you found them." I believe that this quote perfectly summarizes our graduating class. We have participated in every club and played every sport, truly leaving our mark on the history of Terryville High School. We have learned from the people that came before us and set an example for those that are yet to come. These achievements, although less interesting than the wheel, have set a precedent. As we continue to learn and improve, so too will our actions, and the positive influence we have on the world will only expand. The best is yet to come. Therefore, my advice to the class of 2019 is to leave things better than you found. This is the philosophy behind accelerating change, and it is one that we can all take to heart. Imagine the world you want to live in and create it. Be the change you want to see. I would like to give one last thank you to all of the wonderful people I've had the privilege of calling my classmates for both the things that have happened and the things that are yet to come. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce the Terryville High School Class of 2019 valedictorian, Diana Ironimo.
Good evening, Mayor Merchant, Police Chief Krasicki, Board of Education members, District Administration, Mr. Holtz, Mr. Vigliotti, faculty and staff, family, friends, and fellow graduates. Mr. Reitenbach told me that this has to be funny. Now, I don't know if I can be funny, but I am, in the least, going to attempt to be inspiring. And there's nothing more inspiring than a good quote. To that end, I would like to read the words of everyone's favorite congresswoman, Parks and Rec's Miss Leslie Knope, who once said, "Let's embark on a new journey. Let's break out a map. Not the old, out-of-date one that shows where we've been, but a crisp, new one that shows where we might go. Let's embark on a new journey and see where it takes us." Although today is the official day that we all go our separate ways, tomorrow is the day we will focus on the future. So celebrate the last 13 years and everyone's amazing individual accomplishments. But also be sure to take some time to think about your future as you transition into tomorrow. There are a few things that are essential to making this substantial transition. The first thing that is worth highlighting is partnership. There is nothing more important in this world than each other. And there is nothing more detrimental to this world than creating a separation between yourself and others. Collaboration exists in such a way that in the path of learning about one another, it opens the opportunity to develop the best qualities of oneself. I'm not going to tell you to be successful. The definition of success is too vague and indeterminate anyway. What I will do, however, is tell you to make meaningful relationships. Because with them, success is not only evident, but also a direct result of all the efforts demonstrated. Effort in the betterment of others will help both you and them without fail. An optimal means of pursuing this exists through service. Whether it be traveling halfway across the world to Ethiopia in an attempt to assist the local clinics and schools, or simply volunteering your time, collecting goods, or helping at your local shelter. Service is a key element of the unity of humanity. As everything completed alone is enhanced when done together, this foundation for the future of each other and society is key for the continuance of any progress. Some say the road to success is a lonely road, but the road to success, which includes and bolsters others, is ripe with both connections and prosperity. So build your bridges, don't burn them. And remember that your mind is not the only one that exists in the world. Never underestimate how someone else's personal experiences and mindset can bring unique and beneficial perspective to your life, yielding unmeasurable wealth. Another aspiration worth highlighting is positivity. There is an unmatched distinction in bringing positivity to others in any situation. It turns an activity into an adventure, a begrudging task into a pleasant memory, and a stranger into a friend. To be positive is to view your own life as an opportunity, but it is also to understand and attempt to bring happiness to others. And really, just be nice. For all of the hate, the separation, and the harm that is spread throughout the world, there is nothing we can do but put forth even the smallest effort to combat it. The strongest force in the world is kindness. It is the only thing that builds, unites, and cultivates others. It is also the greatest accomplishment we can achieve. Beyond all success, all potential that you hold as an individual, being kind to others supersedes them by far. You can be a doctor, CEO, mechanic, engineer, teacher, chef, parent, or even the president. But what you do is worth nothing unless you do it with kindness. No one is going to follow the exact same path in life, but the decency and acceptance of others has the potential to unite us with a worthy common goal. As Logan just told us, we as a class of 2019 have a responsibility to make the world a better place. We are not and will not be the silent generation, and we should never remain silent throughout life. Every single person sitting on stage today holds their individual potential to make a change in the world. Not only that, but it is our responsibility to ensure that we not only maximize our individual potential, but put effort toward the benefit of others as well. In this way, true and lasting change is bound to reach beyond just ourselves. The only way to better the world is to do it together. Support rather than dissension creates change. A supportive community is one that endures. We must focus on being not only the best versions of ourselves, but the best version of our society. Finally, on a more personal note, I just want to say that you are all amazing. I really do love you guys, and while it is a bittersweet day today, I have full confidence that this is not the last you will hear of the 2019 graduates of Terryville High School. Great people foster great things. Go out and be successful, but don't let your success be defined by the size of your paycheck or your status. Real, true success is determined more by your ability to reach your goals, and doing so with kindness and love. The impact this will make the world a better place to live. Because in the end, we're all in this together. Thank you.
Thank you, all three of you. At this time, I'd like to have Mr. Keene come out with a few of his guests. And while we're at it, we'll have some of our seniors stand up and join them.
Yikes.
Thank you, Mr. Keene. At this time for our final speech of the evening, I'd like to invite up Ms. Karen Kolesa, Vice Chairman of the Board of Education.
Welcome to our graduates, their families, and my fellow community members. When I was preparing for this speech, I asked my own children for advice, and they urged me to keep it short. Keeping that in mind, I tried to think about the one piece of advice that I thought would be most important to share with you as you enter into the next phase of your life. One of the most important qualities you can possess is that of perseverance. The ability to push yourself beyond what is comfortable and easy, and to challenge yourself to what you believe you can or cannot do, is a skill that takes both mental and physical practice. As you begin your journey into adulthood, always remember to be strong, to be kind, and to persevere. Good luck and congratulations, graduates.
All right, for the moment that we've all been waiting for, I'm going to introduce our assistant principal. I know we're not cheering that much for Mr. Vigliotti, but we'll have Mr. Vigliotti come up and let's get these guys their diplomas.
Ready? Diplomas will now be awarded to row one. Diana Christine Ironimo. Logan Joseph Morneau. Benjamin Roger Baudouin. Jonah Aldi. Jacob Hunter Alsobrooks. Sebastian Mario Alvarez. Mohammed Hashem Alzoubi. Kara Marie Andrews. Timothy Francis Armstrong. Colin Michael Bamrick. Brianna Bollier. Kayla Marie Bollier. Austin Begin. Forrest Bertrand Fender. Diplomas will now be awarded to row two. Haley Bledsoe. Donald Boyd. Colby William Brown. Justin Robert Carasone. Kaylee Amber Chapoulis. Isabella Marie Christiana. Christina Gray Christopher. Christopher Harry Gray Christopher. Jordan Angelina Cody. Jordan Elizabeth Conklin. Zachary Tyler Cook. Daniel James Corrigan. Charles Jacob Cotton. Diplomas will now be awarded to row three. Caitlin Marie Craighill. Jake Stephen Daly. Riona Dermaku. Jenna Camille DeSalners. Kayla Paige DeSalners. Heather Elizabeth Devona. Annalisa Lindsay Domestico. Sabrina Marie Eldred. Yariana Marie Elias. Tori Lynn Fennelly. Michael Robert Fisher. Alexander Michael Folmsby. Brianna Marie Foster. Rachiba Luana Frederick. Anthony Brian Garuti. Joseph Andrew Giamatti. Diplomas will now be awarded to row 4. Devin Gertsch. Isabella Eve Green. Christine Isabel Gutierrez. Valerie Ann Hart. Michael James Hills. Derek Todd Holman. Lindsay K. Hotchkiss. Kayla Summer Haginski. Ryan Houston Hume. Kara Elizabeth Iwano. Ryan. Nope. Take it. Lauren Jacobs. Anthony John Jobaggi. Taylor Lauren Johnson. Jacob Christian Kellerstead. Audrey Marie Chemis. Diplomas will now be awarded to row 5. Lindy Marie Kazakowski. David Lawyer. Julia Ann Langeway. Carrie Ann Leduc Santoro. Tina Ferreira Leet. Quinn Harold Lurie. Julia Campos Lima. Joshua Lopez McGuigan. Cody Raymond Lozier. Madison Elizabeth Lombard. Aaron Tyler Maynor. Brian Lynn Maynor. Annabella Marie Manners. Haley Rebecca Marin. Ezekiel Marrero. Ramon Luis Martinez. Diplomas will now be awarded to row 6. Alexander William McCarville. Andrew McLaughlin. Alexia Lee McClellan. Robert Marcel Middlebrook. Kyle Evan Miranda. Alexa Elizabeth Nelson. Wade Daniel Emke. Giovanna Ian Patterson. Dylan Jacob Pichet. Levi Pearson. Jordan Elizabeth Pilbin. Nicholas Frederick Piper. Kyle Anthony Posadas. Stephanie Nicole Poulin. Ashlyn Renee Presnitsky. Samantha Elise Ridgway. Mackenzie Stacia Robinson Lawrence. Arim Sidru. Diplomas will now be awarded to row 7. Cade Scott Sanchez. Jillian Rose Shine. Bailey William Schuster. Gianna Marie Saletti. Orenda Alice Sr. Ardonis Shahini. William James Sheehy. Nicole Emma Tessman. Brendan John Theriault. Aaron Thurman. Angelina Torello. Corey Joseph Turner. Justin Michael Van Delft. Angel Gabriel Vargas Maldonado. Angel Alexis Vasquez. Amaya Cyan Ballone. Zachary Michael Voisin. Garrick John Webster. Michael Lynn White. Ashley Michelle Yocabinas. John Thomas Yocabinas. Seniors, at this time, please move your tassels from the right side of your cap to the left. And please stand. And now, family members, friends, fellow students, faculty, and distinguished guests, I am honored to present to you the Terryville High School graduating class of 2019.